Alright, other questions? Sure, man, tell us what you want to know. Let's do it. He's really into these questions. Who exactly are those people inside the church? Truth is, I don't really know. None of us do. I don't know how many there are. All we've seen are glimpses. You haven't even seen them and you want the police involved? Well, he leans in for emphasis, there's also the machinery. When I first scouted the place back in February, it was abandoned, empty. It took some time getting the crew together, so about 2 weeks ago, we came here hoping to set the stuff up. Suddenly there are all these strange machines lying around in there. Noid says one of them has wires running into bowls of water. Wires. Into water. Never seen anything like it. Egghead says, Andre, tell him about the feeling. Oh yeah, and it felt like there was some thing in there with us, watching us from the dark. Egghead says, no, the other one. Which other one? I'm not as in touch tune with my emotions as you are, Egg. Felt like silence. Awful silence. But you haven't physically seen anyone? Not exactly. We've just seen someone who we think is a woman go in and out of the church a couple times, and we felt someone or something eyeing us inside, but that's kind of it. So how can you be sure they're burnouts and dope heads if you haven't even seen them? Well, honestly, I can't, but I am. Ridwick says, this is a below-feeble attempt at avoidance. Basically, he is attempting to weaponize idiocy. Wow, you can't, but you do. I should add weaponized idiocy to my own repertoire. Hey now, he furrows his brow, I'm 70% sure they're substance abusers. Don't let all that technology fool you. He makes little quotation marks with his fingers when he says technology. Where do you think drugs come from? What was that about something watching you? Like, you aren't alone, you know? Noid says, it wasn't quite human, if you know what I mean. Redrick says, not human, as in a ghost? Do you know what he means? It was this dark shape climbing upside down along the ceiling, like some kind of crab man. Oh boy. Now they're making me think of stuff like The Grudge. A crab man? Yeah, you know, the way it was climbing up and around the ceiling, like a crab. Noid agrees. It was stalking a cell, exhibiting ambush behavior. Encyclopedia says, odd. Crabs are usually marine creatures, and not known for climbing walls. Are you sure there was a crab man? Yeah, totally. I mean, I didn't personally see it. A cell was alone that time, but I believe her. If she comes out running and says there's a crab in there, there's a crab in there. Noid says, you should ask her about it, but be nice. Don't tell her you don't believe in the crab. Logic says, there probably is no crab man. Don't let them draw you in with this nonsense. Can you tell me more about this machinery? You should talk to Noid about that. I just got a distinct burnout and dopehead sign from them. Probably jacked up to some snuff station, too. Probably. Very likely. You mentioned some kind of ecclesiasts own the church? Who are these ecclesiasts? Oh yeah, that's a Meteoran name for the founding party. Thought it'd be cool to use it. Redrick says, if you don't know what the founding party is, there might be a way to mask it with minor demagoguery. Before we go on, what do you mean by Meteoran? You know, of Meteo. Concerning Meteo. Meteo? A country. On Monday? He looks at you, squinting his eyes to see if you're kidding. On the Monday Isola. Encyclopedia says, one of the poorest of the first world nations today, but once a great ancient civilization. Capital? Thalakos by Pesantic. Mask it. Okay. Now humor me, Andre. What is the founding party? Come to think of it, I've never really looked them up, you know. I can't give you a precise definition. They're a very powerful religious organization. And? And they have roots in ancient mass society. He pauses. And they're the custodians of the Pernicanassian Church, Plus they anoint the innocents. They, like, made the innocentric system now. Now, Andre, in your opinion, would this ancient religious organization who anoints the innocents want a club for Anodic music in one of their churches? Totally. There's a trace of doubt in his voice. Egghead says, the Pernicassian church is about love. Anodic music is about love. I got love for my Pernicassian posse. Love is the relay out of death. We dance! He violently shakes the tape player as if to see if he can break it. Love is hardcore! Noid says unity. Andre yells, unity! Egghead says, make some noise for my Insulindian posse. He turns the volume up, then looks at you with a knowing nod, as if it's obvious you will now break into dance. Physical instrument says, you feel it. The anodes and the cathodes coursing through you. Anodes and the cathodes coursing through you. Your big toe starts tapping along to the bass as if testing the waters. Alright, well, maybe they'll be... give me more info if I seem into what they're into. So, enjoy the beat. Feels good. I don't quite understand what you're talking about. What's a posse? Your posse is like your people, man, Egghead says. Like you got your cop posse, you look out for each other, and you party together. That's a posse. Esprit de Corps says, and where is your posse, detective? Nothing comes to you. The world is silent. I guess love can be pretty hardcore. Oh yeah, it can, Egghead says. He's coming around, Andre nods at the friend, then turns to you with a mischievous grin. You're getting it. I now understand it was lame of me to suggest otherwise. Anodic music is about love, and so is the Pernicassian church. Yeah, Yakukata, the place to be, Egghead says. Empathy says he seems ecstatic that you share his vision of Pericarnassianism. Noid says, do it for the masses, do it for the crew. His friend forms a fist with a screwdriver still in his hand, approvingly so. Andre says, I didn't want to say it, but it was pretty lame of you to imply otherwise. Anyway, you got more questions? The one with the large head is still looking at you, nodding his head, waiting for your body to start moving. I wanted to ask you about this tent full of equipment. Yes? What? I see you brought your own water. Yeah, good to have, bitch to carry. When I first scouted the place, I did some reconnaissance. I'm not sure the church even has running water. And it's distilled, too. Oh? He doesn't know what to say. It's the one they sell at the fuel station. Drama says, it's like he's lying to you, my liege, but he's slippery enough that there's nothing for you to grab a hold of. Alright, enough of this. He nods enthusiastically, Andre, no doubt a little relieved. Godly? I'm gonna pass on that. Be careful in there, officer, and tell us how it goes, yeah? We'll be here. Alright, what about these other people? A young man, Egghead, with a peroxide blonde hair, holds up a Harman Wowshi tape player, nodding along to the music. He looks at you with a knowing smile and says,
hardcore!
Is it?
It's hardcore!
You're just gonna keep saying it's hardcore, aren't you?
Skibbadee, skibba danger! I am the rearranger!
I like that. Authority says, your cop training did not prepare you for this. What to do? Inland Empire says, could there have been a right way out of this Garden of Forking Paths, you think? New task for solve the Egghead puzzle. There has to be some way to talk to this person. You just haven't found it yet. It's definitely not about signs. What if you just try again, find your way out of this maze of things to say? And help ravers start a nightclub. The ravers asked you to help turn the church into a dance club, but they're already... but there are already some people inside. Find out who those people are and what they want. Look into the spookers in the church. If there's actually anyone in there at all. Faster! Harder! Cather? The young man with the tape recorder acknowledges your return. When he looks at you, he squints as though you were the setting sun.
This is hardcore.
Say nothing.
Hardcore!
Still say nothing.
Hardcore to the mega!
Alright!
Here comes the night! Back to the heavyweight jam!
Says the young man with the tape player and the large Brodero boots. Lung-shaped trees sprout on his silver belt buckle.
Hardcore! Hardcore!
Nothing.
Hardcore to the mega!
Nothing.
Internally coherent!
Nothing.
All core! All right! Yeah!
Nothing. He furrows his brow as his very large head traces the sublime, invisible movement of the music in the very real air of the stuffy tent.
Hardcore! Ah!
He lets out an anguished roar over the feeblish, obviously not too hardcore, beat below. So hardcore!
Is it though?
He stops dead in his tracks, tilting his head to one side. It is!
But is it? I mean, really?
He tilts his head to the other side like an owl. Now I notice what he's saying are the options I had to choose earlier. I was thinking that too.
I am the mic enforcer. I am the chick's checker. Yeah!
Hmm. Well, that's something in, like, German.
Wie close!
Says the young man with the tape player and the large Brodero boots.
True, hard, full, core! Hardcore! Hardcore to the mega! Internally coherent! All core! Alright! Yeah! Hardcore! Ah!
No, but seriously, I'm a little worried it isn't.
The question is, what is the question?
Just answer the question.
But there was no question.
We have not solved this. Solve the egghead puzzle.
We're close. True, hard, full, car.
Is it?
It's hard car.
I don't know what to say to that.
Skibber D, skibber danger. I am the rearranger. We're close. True, hard, full, core. Hardcore. Hardcore to the mega. Internally coherent.
I was wondering if you knew who killed the mercenary hanging behind the Whirling and Rags hostel.
Good morning, yeah. 1, 2, 3. Yekokata, the place to be.
You said that before. What is this Yekokata, the place? Why is this Yekokata, the place to be? What does that mean?
Yekokata, the hardcore place.
Encyclopedia says, in an intricate system of irrigation networks pockmarking the earth, intermittent seas of phosphorus mud, ripped tarpaulin fluttering in the wind, a pair of molten rubber boots also comes to mind. All in all, a truly hardcore place. Okay. I'm not sure how helpful that was.
We're close. True, hard, full, core. Hardcore. Hardcore to the mega. Internally coherent.
Internally coherent.
All core. All right. Yeah. Hardcore. Ah.
So hardcore.
Is it though?
I was just thinking that a moment ago.
One mind, one spirit. There's no other world. There's no other life. We're close. True, hard, full, core. Hardcore.
But is it? I mean, really?
Yeah!
Drama says the young man adds a capital G before the H in his yeah, and ags. This produces a guttural, Gottwaldian accent and makes him sound more animal, more in it. Encyclopedia says, or maybe it's not Gottwaldian, maybe it's Aranyes. Maybe it's a homage to Aranyes, where Arno van Eek is from, judging by his name. Could you be listening to an Arno van Eek creation right now? So this is the famous van Eek I'm hearing?
You know about him?
He moves his mouth, but sound doesn't come out. His eyes are the size of saucers. Looks like you've rendered him speechless.
You know van Eyck?
Van Eyck. Yeah, I'm a major Eyckhead.
Wow!
Noid looks at you, the skinny wraith, with some disbelief.
So am I! So am I!
He begins to shake his hand so everyone would understand.
Oh, is that why they call you Egghead? Because...
Andre almost falls over backwards from the realization.
Egghead to the mega! The K became the G! The boy became the man! The Advent?
We still have this puzzle, though.
We're close. True, hard, full, core! Hardcore! Yeah!
Yeah!
The Y to the E to the A 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 to the G to the H to the hyphen mark! Yeah!
Okay.
We're close. True, hard, full, core! Hardcore! Hardcore to the mega! Internally coherent! All core! Alright! Yeah!
Please tell me, what exactly are you doing?
Gotta get the people going!
Why?
I'm the party boy. It's my job.
What is a party boy?
Hardcore party 25/7 beyond the winter's orbit style!
This guy's hilarious. Encyclopedia says there's a place far away in Katla, beyond a certain latitude known as Winter's Orbit, where there are 25 hours in a day. It is a tremendously cold place, abandoned to drunks and failed rock stars, full of eternite depression and half-finished ski-flying hills. The Suru live there. Okay.
We're close. True, hard, full, core! Hardcore! Hardcore to the mega! Internally coherent. All core. All right. Yeah. Gotta get the people going. I'm the party boy. It's my job. Hardcore party 25/7 beyond the winter's orb.
Yeah. I thought I could say something to him about that.
True. Hard. Full. Core. Hardcore. Hardcore to the mega. Internally coherent. All core. All right. Yeah. Hardcore!
Is it though? But is it? I mean, really?
The question is, what is the question?
No, but seriously, I'm a bit worried it isn't.
He frowns and starts bobbing his head back and forth once more. Somehow we've solved the puzzle. I still don't understand though. Electrochemistry says, don't be alarmed. Everything is okay. He isn't actually worried. Everything is still super hardcore. What he probably means is it could be even more so. You said you were worried. Why? What do you think is wrong with the music? There's nothing wrong with it. I'm still in love with the hardcore. He turns pensive all of a sudden. Sometimes I just feel like anodic music is in its infancy, you know? For example, take this Arno van Eyck jam I've been pumping for the last month, and we'll continue pumping for the rest of 51. Isn't something holding it back from being hyper? He thinks for a moment, then his expression clears. It's like it's only ultra. Andre says, I think it's super hardcore, but you're right, it's not hyper hardcore. Conceptualization says, if anything, it sounds a bit proto. Like it's not fully formed yet. You might be a moribund alcoholic and a failed cop, but you're pretty certain the thing cannot be both proto and hardcore. It's proto, not hardcore at all. Wah! Culture cop! I think you might be right, but how could it become hardcore then? I know it in my heart, but I cannot think it in my head. If this is not hardcore, how could anything be? Try to think if anything could make it harder core. What? He looks at you with customary amazement. Guys, there's something happening in his head. Think even harder. Oh yeah, he's doing it. Logic says, but you're not. This is almost certainly a matter that surpasses the limits of reason. My imagination fails me. I know, so does mine. He laughs and shakes his head. Wait, I just remembered something. I'm the police. Uh-uh. The young man is bursting with anticipation. Nothing. Me being the police isn't gonna help us. Oh. Sounds suspiciously like a question. I thought the question was, what is the question? No, this is the answer. I can't help you with this right now. I need something else, something extra. Yuck! He's not even the slightest bit disappointed. Are you a thought reader? No nation, but transnation. No war, but class war. Does that mean you're a thought reader? Noid says, don't be a lunatic. Of course he isn't. Jermaine here just yells random things. Odds are, sooner or later, one of them will come off as thought reading. Is his real name Jermaine? Yeah! Revachol Imperative! Unless you're thinking Revachol Imperative right now. Anyway, I have a similar thing happen with eggs yelling. I know what you mean. Lie. Say, but I was thinking Revachol Imperative. That's screwed up, man. Lying like that. And a cop, too. So you're not a thought reader, you're a communist? He's not a communist. It's just something he likes to yell. He picked it up from a tape jockey at the Palaceum. She was a communist, though. Yeah! With a rebel yell! Best not to be a communist. Having extreme views on issues is detrimental to understanding all sides. Oh, sure, I can do that, he nods. If you want that, I can avoid taking a stand. Noid says, please don't turn him into a moralist. Andrew says, I don't even know what to say to that. Don't be a moralist. Wait, what am I saying? You should consider your choice carefully and rationally. I leveled up for that. Ah, he yells. You guess Egghead is a moralist now. Really? Just like that. Tell me something else, Egghead. It's time to compromise. He looks at you with an almost impossibly wide, shining grin, looking to see if you approve. Almost there. Could use just a bit more something. Incremental change. Appropriate. I'm swiftly moving toward a situation which pleases nobody. Is your real name Jermaine? D'accord, hardcore. Jermaine Egghead. Andrew says, basically yes it is. Why are there lungs on your belt buckle? Lungs are for love. Why would lungs be for love? When Dolores Day was anointed Innocence, her lungs started glowing through her body, for the world loved her, and she loved back. Yeah. Conceptualization says, why wouldn't they be? Are the lungs not the place where you hold the breath of your soul? Really? I think so. Well, the lungs are where you hold the breath of your soul, aren't they? I don't know what that is. Oh, I'm an expert on anodic music now? Okay, maybe your body can tell you what Arno van Eyck's jam is missing to make it harder core. Success. You know it in your lungs where the pressure should vibrate, in your heart that's alone, and in your solar plexus where the hit should land. So does every chordate animal. Needs more bass. What? The young man makes a sudden move, like he's about to turn the volume down, but that would be ridiculous. And a melody. A good melody is what makes the song really stick, so that you can't get it out of your head anymore. Point at my head. Wow, okay. We should start with the melody. But where would we get that stuff from? I don't know. I was thinking you would know. I'm sorry, I don't know anything about Anodic music. I'm just a party boy. I get the people going and say it's hardcore. Empathy says he feels ashamed he can't be of more service to the future of dance music. Oh my god, we're gonna help the future of dance music now. Okay. Alright, I'll see if I can come with something up with something on my own. A citizen investigation. The young man falls silent with appreciation. He even tries to contain his smile as if it could hinder your investigation. Andre says, basically what you need to find here is a tape with some banging music on it so that Egghead could use it to remix Van Eyck's jam. Noid says, yeah, maybe that street hawker across the pawn shop has some tapes to sell. That's just an idea. Oh, the guy who's selling the shoes and stuff? Andrew says, anyway, that's all yours to figure out, cop man. Cop man! Yells Egghead. Oh, could I use it for this? Hey, I have a tape with... Oh, no. The tape we want to use... No. If that's the tape I'm thinking of... Well, it's either evidence, which we need to hold on to, if it's the hanged man's tape... Or he might be talking about the other tape we picked up, which we want to use to do... What's a sad song? I don't see how that would make it more hardcore. You never know, though. But we want to use it to do karaoke with. So maybe we'll do our karaoke and then come back here with the tape. Alright, goodbye, Egghead. Alright, here comes the night! Alright. We've been running for over an hour, these people. Make Van Eyck's jam harder core. You can feel it. This music could hit so much harder. It just needs a few tweaks. Walk back to the canal so you can find any tapes that could work as a melody, then bring them back to Egghead for remixing. Find a tape with a melody for Egghead. Alright, finally we talked to Noid.
So you had a talk with Andre, and now you want to discuss things with Noid? Good.
Skin shows through the holes in the Speed Freak's too large sweater. In front of him, an open toolbox full of carpentry tools and parts.
It's good you talked to Andre first. Gave me time to get a reading on your sign. Can't really talk to people before you get a reading.
He runs his hand through his hair, which is combed back in mock seriousness, and continues to fiddle with some gears. Sign? Yeah, gotta compare. See if we align. Interesting. I suck at socializing, man. Even now, our sign synchronization is way off, but I'll see what I can do. He continues to rearrange his tools. I saw a sticker on the padlock. Can you tell me anything about it? A sticker? You mean the yellow one? Can you describe it to me? Conceptualization says interesting. He wants you to describe it, though he already knows what it looks like. Why describe it if you already know what I mean? So I can hear you do it. Sometimes the outside gaze helps us reflect on things. Andre says, Noid, don't bother our guests with your games. Piss off, Andre. Me and Mr. Cop are trying to discuss art. You shouldn't talk like that. I don't mind a little foul language here and there. Cool. The ban on foulness? That's the moralist plot to alienate us from our bodily functions so they can control us more fully. Anyhow, what was the sticker like? Okay, it's a yellow circle, the human face, with X's for eyes and a smile underneath. I think the X's mean the guy is dead. Good, good. He likes what he's hearing. What'd you want to know? Was I right? Is it a dead guy smiling? Yes. You're the 23rd person to get it right. And I've asked 23 people. Looks like it's a dead guy smiling to the entire human race. Why do you think that's so? We are all the same. Same eyes, same smiles, same death. Okay, what does it mean? He defeated history. We're living in the age of history, and in the eyes of history, we're always already dead. But how can we ever smile then? Because history is a lie, and so are its deaths. The present moment of life and death are the hardcore. The hardcore expels death. He thinks, Well, maybe he's not dead. Maybe he's just really ecstatic about the beats. I'm thinking we should sell this. It should be sold, he nods, but not by us. What makes the sticker so modern? Simplicity was brought to us by classical Soleus modernism, but that was a tasteful, harmonious simplicity, right? While hardcore is not tasteful or outwardly harmonious, it's a warning shot. This will be dangerous. The echo of man's loss haunting him. The sticker, the clothes, the music, same thing. You come up with this stuff by yourself? Not alone. Many people are thinking the same thing right now. We all see the same smiling dead guy in a couple of X's and a circle. And a curve. The beat is the same for all. I think we've exhausted the subject for now. I guess one could write an entire treatise on the thing, but what for? What about now? Are the signs all right now? Nah, huh. Still strongly out of sync. Stage gamma disalignment. What? He examines a small metal bolt in his hand. You heard me. Why are you called Noid? He picks up some sort of a widget. The hardcore aesthetic is esoteric. It is not meant to be discussed with the law at this moment. I don't understand what that means. Okay, we got a task for syncing the signs with Noid. I can see that. Further sign matching would do no good for us. One way to achieve sign synchronicity would be by getting us into the church. Tell me about the machines you saw in the church. He cringes. Weird stuff. Specialized. There was a data processor and some sort of long-wave machinery. Wires going into water. Gives us a spy sign or some screwed-up Sumerian science sign. You know, the kind that goes headfirst into the supernatural. Encyclopedia says, the People's Republic of Samara is a product of Revachol's sister revolution on the Grand Isola. It's known as a severely degenerated rogue state. What's wrong with the supernatural? Nothing's wrong with it. It should definitely be researched. You can still do sick stuff with it, though. The supernatural, so you think it's real? That it actually exists? Most of it doesn't exist, but there's also the stuff that isn't allowed to exist because the moralists think it's too dangerous for the plebes. Psionic powers, pale-related diseases, pretenders pretending to be human, folk rites, that kind of stuff. Alright, maybe I'll come back later. Sync the signs with Noid. Noid doesn't want to talk to you. The signs are not in sync. Guess you need to help him and his friends out somehow. Prove that you're one of the crew. Who knows what he'll tell you. Well, I can level up. What do we want to level up? What does the Inland Empire help with? Oh, you know what? Empathy. Empathy seems to come into play a lot. Maybe we'll level that up. Understand others, work your mirror neurons again. Alright, done. Empathy 5. Hardcore! And we can go out and ask... What's her name? About the crab thing she saw? A cell? A seal? The shaggy-haired girl... Shaggy-haired girl kneels on the sea ice. She looks up as you approach.
So you talk to my associates, right? Are you going to help us? With the church, I mean.
Can't say. Gotta ask questions first.
Shoot.
A cold wind blows. She breathes on her hands for warmth. The others told me you went inside the church. What did you see there? Oh, that. You're not going to believe me. There's no point in me telling you. Rhetoric says she's less prone to blurting out Crab Man than the others. We'll see. Go ahead and tell me. Okay, she nods. I went in and saw a woman next to one of those machines there. Noid calls it a mainframe. She was dressed like someone who's being raised by their grandmother, you know. Strange old clothes. Had this absent expression. Didn't say anything. Just stood still. Go on. And then, you know, right behind her, a man crawled down the wall. Upside down, like a crab, down the church wall. I think the woman didn't even know he was there. He was completely silent. He stopped right before he got to the floor, then just hung there like that, looking at me. Right at me. I turned around and walked out. End of story. Like a crab, you say? The lieutenant nods. His face is stone. What did this crab man look like? It was too dark, she shakes her head. I couldn't tell exactly. Jama says, come on, she obviously could. She already went into detail. Come on, quit stalling on me. What did he look like? He looked like a banger, okay? He was all muscular and stuff. Had a mesh tank top. I know it sounds ridiculous, but that only made it scarier in a way. Kim says, a crab and a banger? He raises an eyebrow. Yes, a banger, as in a mesk gang member. I know what it sounds like, but that's what I saw. You were wrong. I do believe you. She raises a brow. Why? What would you stand to gain? Nothing, she says. Anyway, what else? I'd like to know more about your associates. My associates? She blows on her chilled fingers. I haven't got much to say about them. What do you mean? You must know something about them. Of course I do. I just don't tell people about my friends and who they are and so on. I don't provide information on them. Rhetoric says, to the cops. What about you? Tell me something about yourself. Me? I'm a silver bird. Aha. Okay, maybe I'll ask later about all this. Get Asel to talk about her as associates. Okay, we got stuff to do here. I don't want to take the tape recorder. Asel refused to talk about her friends. Maybe she'll open up later, after you've helped them set up the nightclub. Oh, we're not only getting inside, but helping her to... and getting the people out, we're helping to set it up. Measure head. Oh, we can walk around this way now. A school of fish huddle around the fence post, then scatter into the dark. Well, I don't know what we're going to be facing here. People and... a crab man? An old lady? And other people? Anyway, we leave off where we started 2 episodes ago. About to go into this church. Hopefully for real this time. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.